In this video, I will show you how to change the default client. So if you want to know what is default client, just I'm logging off from here and close everything from here. So when you double click on this entry, the first client which is displaying here, it is called default client. I want to change this default client to something else. So what, how to do? So you can log in as either DDIC or SAP star into any client like 00 or 001. From here, in earlier video we have imported all the profiles using RZ10 key code. Go to RZ10 key code and click on the possible options button and select the default profile. And the version number of this default for profile is 00001. And once you change something inside this profile file, this version will be changed to 00002. And select extended maintenance and click on the change button. So these are all the parameter names and parameter value is this. And if you want to change the default client, that is login/system client, this is the parameter name, this is parameter value. Just double click on it and it will show the details in next window. From here you can change it to some other client, like instead of 001 I am putting 000. You click on copy button. As soon as I click on copy button, so it will record the change options, changes, what are all the changes have done in this particular system and changed by whom and what date and what time, everything will be recorded. Okay, once you click on the copy button, just go back from here and again you click on the copy button here so that the data will be, the changed profile was transferred, means it will be transferred to the operating system level file as well as to the database. Okay, once you do this step, just click on the back button from here and the default profile is still showing as 1 and we have made some changes, it is not saved, we have to click on the save button, click on save so that the it will be saved. Okay, incorrect parameter values detected, display values, I don't want to see any incorrect parameter values, click on no. And do you want to activate the profile? Yes, I want to activate, click yes. So as soon as I click on S, version number is changed to 2, that means number 2 profile is activated, profile default version so and so, the 2 saved and activated. Click on continue button. So in the next screen, the effect of activating a profile is simply that the profile is stored at operating system level. Say administration data. For the profile to the take effect for a particular application server, you have to restart the application server. We have to restart the application server to get the changes affected. Okay, just click on continue button here, log off from the screen, that is log off from the SAP system and stop the SAP system. I am right clicking on top, that is dev, and click on stop, click OK here. Wait until it is stopped, then we can click on start button to start the SAP system. Then we can check it up, the default client, whether it is changed or not. That is the purpose of profile files. With the by using profile files, we can change the parameters which are useful for running SAP systems. It should be stopped. Yes, it is stopping. Status down means it is going to stop. It is stopping. Yellow color. Nothing is there here. Gray color. Completely it should become gray. Yes, completely it is became gray. Now again start the server. Click on the start. Click OK. And we have to wait until this color turns to green. And this is the dialog instance. It is not required. Actually, if you don't want to have the dialog instance, don't install dialog instance. Only central instance is enough. Dialog instance is only for increasing the capacity of the server SAP system. More number of users can communicate, like more number of users can request SAP system to give results. Okay, it is started. Now let us double click on this entry. We should see the default client 000 because we have changed to 000 from 001. Double click on it here. So the default client is changed to 000. In that way, using profiles, we can change the parameters. So you can directly DDIC and password. That's all about changing default client. I think you understood this very well. Thanks for watching.